Sacramento, how you feeling tonight, huh? You guys doing well, man? You doing well? Let me hear you.
That's good. That's good, man. I'm feeling well, too. I'm feeling good, too. And honestly, for the first time in a long time, aside from kind of getting my butt kicked a little bit last night by Samoa Joe, I'm feeling really good. Because you guys, you've been through it with me for the last 6 months, dude. It's been like a roller coaster. But that's just life, right? Highest of highs, lowest of lows. We've all been there, and you guys have been there with me through all of that. And we've all been there. We've been in those moments where you feel so low that you just want to give up, man. You just want to crawl into a hole, shut off the world, but you can't do that, right? Now you gotta stand up, you gotta keep fighting, you gotta struggle, you gotta embrace the sucky part of life just as much as the good stuff, man. And that's exactly what I've done. You gotta look in the mirror. All of us, we've been there. You gotta look in the mirror, you gotta figure out who you are and who you wanna be. And if those two things don't line up, you gotta do something about it. And that's what I did. I looked in the mirror and I realized I'm still Seth freaking Rollins. And everything kind of came full circle in the last month, man. WrestleMania, I slayed the King of Kings. And last night I got some payback on Samoa Joe. So for me, there's really only one thing left to do. I want the beast. I want Brock Lesnar. I want the Universal Championship. And I've been to Suplex City, and I'm not afraid to go back.
Seth, man, we've been on the same page recently. And I gotta be honest, man, I respect you. You are the one-legged man who won at WrestleMania. But me, I'm the one-armed man who became the very first Universal Champion. You remember that, right? You remember that when my arm was hanging from my body and I still beat you? Oh, and by the way, I never actually lost that title, so no offense. But when it comes to talking about facing Brock Lesnar, the line starts here.
Brock, 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 Brock. Y'all sound like a couple of chickens. Look, I know a little something about Brock Lesnar. He does what he wants, when he wants, and he fights when he wants, which, let's face it, ain't all that often. I think Monday Night Raw should be about fighting champions. That's why I'll fight anybody, anytime, any place, anywhere. I mean, I've had fights I didn't even know I had. I've had fights by accident, so if y'all are gonna talk about a title, you ought to be talking about this, because as of now, this is the number one championship on Monday Night Raw, and I'm itching to get to some action. Awesome! Hold up. talk about action, first and foremost, these two haven't earned anything. And quite frankly, Dean, you are an embarrassment as a champion. If anyone deserves that title, it is me. I'm the one that made it relevant. I made it prestigious. People lined up to fight me. I'm the guy that made the Intercontinental Championship mean something.
You're also the latest member of the Finn Balor Just Kick My Ass Club.
Yeah, about that, you cheap-shotted me. Congratulations. By the way, that proves me right. You, sir, are a coward. And you don't deserve to be Intercontinental Champion. None of you do. See, when I was Intercontinental Champion, I defended it nightly. But you, Dean, you weren't even important enough to defend it at Payback last night. And then there's Seth freaking Rollins. Oh yeah, you used to be the man, but now you hobble on one leg like the gimp you are.
Ah, dude, come on. On one leg, I could still run circles around you in this ring, man.
Well, it's a good thing this isn't a running contest. This, sir, is a WWE ring, and in this WWE ring, I beat people up. There's a reason why everybody hates me. It's because I am the biggest threat on Monday Night.
Shut up!
Look, all right, there's a lot of mudslinging going on right now. It's very confusing. I'm going to fix the whole situation. There is two things we do know. I will face anybody, anytime for the Intercontinental Championship. And two, everybody likes to see The Miz get beat up. So, for instance, who here in Sacramento would like to see Finn Balor beat up The Miz? See, that's a lot of people. Who here in Sacramento would like to see Seth Rollins beat up The Miz? Okay, well, we're gonna make some stuff happen. I'm just gonna take care of business right now. Hold on a sec. One sec.
What are you doing?
It's ringing. Kurt Angle, Dean Ambrose. Yeah, I'm in the ring. Can you see me? Hey, Kurt. Hey, look, Foley gave me your number. Is that okay? Okay, well, I'll make it quick. I got an idea. Hold on.
Hey, what's going on? What'd he say?
Oh, Kurt Angle was not happy that I had his phone number. Look, he did say something else. He made a match for tonight. And he said, and I quote, "Tonight will be The Miz versus Finn Balor versus Seth Rollins in a triple threat match. Number one contender for the Intercontinental Championship. It's true, baby. It's damn true."
I love it.
Wow. How often can you say it was a good decision made by Dean Ambrose?
Well, the decision was actually made by our general manager, Kurt Angle. Thank goodness Ambrose had his phone number, Booker.